fight, the fight you didn't dare to fight last time. Motherfucker, you're addicted to your life, you gotta fight.
Coming up next, it's a UFC heavyweight division collision. So here he is, one of the more prolific takedown artists in the UFC at present. And when you get some praise from Daniel Cormier when it comes to your offensive takedown game, you know you're doing something right.
And you talk about wrestlers and judo players and grapplers, but this guy just combines all of that. He is able to use foot sweeps from the grappling game. He is able to use throws from judo, and he's able to use wrestling from the wrestling game to take people down. He has an array of takedowns at his disposal, and he uses every single one of them. From the speed of the level change to the timing to the knowledge of where to go next when the guy starts to defend, he's truly, truly something special.
I don't think he could take you down, but tonight he doesn't have to. So in this matchup, prevailing wisdom is he'll be able to get this fight to the canvas. Well, you can argue this is the most influential martial artist of all time, the great Bruce Lee, making his walk to the octagon here tonight, champ.
Everybody wants to be Bruce Lee. They say they want to be like Mike. If you're a fighter, you want it to be like Bruce Lee. You want it to be that fast. You want it to be that charismatic. You want it to have an ability to just freeze your opponents. Your speed, your movement, just the diversity in the attacks that you can give your opponents would just confuse people. I mean, I watched him beat a 7-foot Kareem Abdul-Jabbar to stay undefeated.
Right.
If you could do that, you could do anything.
I fear not the man who has practiced 10,000 kicks once. If you're the man who has practiced one kick 10,000 times, Bruce Lee in a nutshell.
Just so wise.
And now our tale of the tape for this heavyweight fight. More than a decade separates these two fighters when it comes to the age. Some differences in height and reach. All right, now with the official introductions, we go inside the octagon of Bruce Buck.
The main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Eve Loving. Now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas, it's time! 5 rounds in the UFC heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner.
This man is a kickboxer, making his professional debut here tonight.
He stands 6'1" tall, weighing in at 198 pounds. Fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, USA, El Presidente. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner.
This man is a mixed martial artist, making his professional debut here tonight.
He stands 5'7" tall, weighing in at 145 pounds. Fighting out of Los Angeles, California, USA, Bruce the Dragon Lee.
Okay, guys, protect yourself at all time. Obey my command at all time. If you want to touch love, do it now. Go back to your corner.
They touch him up, and we are underway. Again, making great use of his length in this matchup. Just unable to quite find that range.
It's such a fast leg kick.
Well, it's been a kick-heavy approach so far, but it has worked out for him, DC. Another nice combination, largely of kicks.
Kick, 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 kick. Until you stop it, he's going to continue to blast those shins into every part of your body. Nice punch lands over the top.
Pretty good job staying patient as he lands the counter strike there. Strong work by Lee. Trying to double up on that jab. Still unable to find that precise range with the high kick.
Got him whip his hip into that kick.
Oh! Huge kick to the body. Going for the spinning side kick to the body, but he missed. Alright, he closes the distance, gets the single collar tie. Glancing right hand, lands upstairs.
Yep.
Oh, left hook to the head, it's blocked. Just missing on the high kick there. Oh, massive head kick there. We'll see if he can finish. Under a minute to go in what has been a wild round one.
Big ball punch land. Now we get back in range. He changes the angle, finds the right spot to land that punch to the head from the clinch. What a body kick.
Oh, and a nice jab by him there. That's going to give his opponent some pressure. Nice connection by him there.
He needs to get on his bicycle, John. He needs to get into space so that he doesn't get finished.
All right, let's check out some of the action, DC, and how about the punching acumen by that fighter in that previous round?
He does not waste anything. He does not loop punches. Everything's tight. Everything's precise. He's a sniper. We always talk about how he's a sniper. He is a sniper. And it showed in that exchange that allowed him to drop his opponent.
Second round underway. The skull. That is as big a strike as he has landed thus far tonight.
Big, massive shot lands. Look at how tough his opponent is, though. Still standing, still in their fight.
Oh, really nice work to keep busy off of his back as he lands some more offense here for Bob. This ground and pound is good. Probably my favorite striking realm in MMA, and he's as good as it gets.
The problem is his opponent is not controlling his posture. He's allowing his opponent to get up, and when he does, he creates this space to land these beautiful ground and pound combinations.
That is a huge shot right there, DC. You don't want to eat too many more of those.
No, and he needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
That shot is blocked by Lee. So a much different approach from him here in round two. Took him a while to find the range, get in his striking rhythm. He has found it here, and as a result, has really picked up the pace in round two.
Head kick.
Misses again with a right punch.
Can't take many of those, you better check. Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one up?
Well, straight right hand has been a good weapon for him. He misses with it there.
Yeah.
Well, the right hand has been there at times, not that time.
He's back in the clinch position. This is where he has done a ton of good work here.
Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining. Nice body kick.
Telegraph that spinning back fist.
Big kick land.
So he gets knocked down, but not out. Let's look back at some of the highlights, DC. A huge round on the other side.
He had him hurt very bad. He found the shot. He got exactly what he wanted. When he saw the opening, he jumped on it, and he hurt his opponent very bad. If he can get back to that one more time, he may end the night.
You ready? You ready?
Third round underway. He continues to land a high number of strikes here, just like he did in the previous round. This is a world-class display of striking here tonight. Oh, beautiful right hook counter. Oh, what a head kick. Oh, significant strike attempt there. Goes to the spinning kick, but he misses.
Beautiful kick.
Straight right, he misses. Oh! Huge right hand!
Dude's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him.
Oh! Wow.
Get right here.
He's got him hurt here. Strong defense there to punish. Absolutely one for the highlight reel right there. A tremendous kick to spell the end of the night for his opponent and for him, I should say, but just caught him flush, full force, beautiful extension on the kick, and the fight was really over as soon as that one made contact. I'm not even sure he was conscious when he hit the canvas. Outstanding performance here tonight. We go inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine's called a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 56 seconds of round number three. Going to winner by knockout, El Presidente.
All right, so there he is, the man of the hour. What a massive knockout for him to get this win in style tonight.
He did everything he needed to do to find the knockout. Now he can celebrate with his family and friends as they earn this spectacular victory.